Hi, I'm Gary Amoroso, Executive Director of the Minnesota Association of School Administrators. Welcome to another edition of Take 5. I want to start off by saying a few words regarding the fall conference that was held in Duluth this past week. I want to thank each of our members who had an opportunity to attend the conference. The feedback that we're receiving has been very, very positive. People thoroughly enjoyed our three general sessions, as well as the various breakouts that were provided. We had a great opportunity to congratulate Kurt Trigestad for being a Green Scholar, as well as our Polaris winner, Chris Richardson. We had a great luncheon where people were recognized, and as I mentioned, from what I'm receiving, it's been a conference that was well received. Over 80 exhibitors were there to provide our members with information and ideas and concepts that will help us all do our work in a more effective and efficient manner. So again, thank you for those that were able to attend. And I know it's only October 1st, but I'm going to put a date in your mind for the future, the 2015-2016 MASE Spring Conference will be held on Thursday and Friday, March 10th and 11th. That conference will be held at the Minneapolis Marriott Northwest, and we're asking you to mark those dates on your calendar so that you'll be able to join your colleagues at our annual spring conference. With that, I'd like to take a minute to just share some information regarding the upcoming Curriculum Leaders of Minnesota and Technology Leaders of Minnesota Instructional Leadership Conference. That conference will be held up in Brainerd at Cragen's Wednesday evening, November 18th through Friday noon, November 20th. This is the first year that we have created a collaborative effort between our Curriculum Leader Component Group and our Technology Leader Component Group to work together to create a conference that truly will focus on the instructional aspects of what we do in our schools. This conference is not only for members of the association, but we're encouraging you to bring a team of members from your district, other administrators, teachers, anyone that you believe has an impact on the instructional practice that is ongoing within your system. We know that it's going to be a great conference. We hope that you will mark your calendar for that conference and look for registration materials to be coming out sometime in October. Also want to mention that our fall committee meetings are going to begin to be held the latter part of October. We have four committees, as I think all of you know. I want to thank those of you that have already signed up for the committees. We're excited that so many of you have chosen to join our committees and that your expertise will help move our association forward. The first committee meeting is the nominating committee. That committee meeting will be held on Monday, October 26th at the MASA offices. I do need to say this is the one committee where we believe we're a little bit short on participants. Dave Christians is the coordinator of those meetings in our office. His email address is appearing on the screen. We're looking for additional members of the association to participate in that nominating committee meeting. If you have an interest, and again, that committee meeting is on Monday, the 26th of October. It's from about 11 a.m. to about 1:30 p.m. in the MASA office in St. Paul. If you have an interest, please email Dave so that we can get you on the list so that when the agendas come out, we'll be able to get that to you. The Legislative Committee, which is a very important committee, as all of you know, will create our platform for us to be approved by our board, will be held on the 26th of October, a Thursday. The Executive Development Committee meeting will be held on the 30th of October, a Friday, and the Federal Advocacy Committee meeting will be held on November 13th. All of the committee meetings will be held at MASA's offices in St. Paul. Finally, I want to mention that we have conducted our annual survey. Thank you for those that participated. The results of the survey in its entirety will be up on our website on the 5th of October. We're very pleased that 91.47% of our members gave a positive response to the question about are we meeting your needs in the areas of professional development. And for question two, 90.7% of our members gave a positive response to the concept that MASA is a unifying force in education. Again, our goal is to have 100% of our members provide a positive response to the strategic plan goals, and we will continue to work to get to that point. If you have questions, suggestions, concerns, please feel free to contact us. As always, thanks for what you do on a daily basis. If I can be of service, please contact me, 651-319-1211. Thank you.